Connor from Nothing But Thieves. How are you doing, mate?
I'm very well. How are you, George?
I'm really well. Thanks so much for coming on. How's your day been? How have you been up to much today, like in this weird sort of time we're living through?
Today? Actually, it's been pretty chill today. What did I do? I went to the gym and I wrote a little bit. Pretty basic day. Pretty dreary outside, so...
Yeah, fair dues. Your music that you've got out now, because that's important. Our record of the week, it is your latest single, Real Love Song. I don't want to pry too much into the meaning and the story of it and everything, but am I right in saying this isn't necessarily your traditional love song?
Yeah, it's quite funny. We were in Malaysia for the first time, back when we could tour. And this Malaysian interviewer just said, oh, you don't have enough love songs. I remember we looked at each other and we were like, we have a few, but I guess it's because not that we try and avoid it, but everyone writes about that generic love song idea. And I think this song was supposed to be about the underbelly of it, you know, the kind of guttural, ugly side, the unrequited side that not a lot of people sing about. We pretty much had the album. We went to a little Airbnb in a village called East Grinstead.
Okay, nice.
And there's the three of us, Dondra and myself, and we wrote this song. It was one of those times that we... melody and the lyric of the music really, really worked very synthetically.
Well, listen, let's hear it. It's our record of the week, Nothing But Thieves on Radio X now. This is Real Love Song. Radio X. So Connor's joining me tonight, and mate, what a chorus on that. I mean, the power, there's the edge in the vocals. It is an absolute belter, mate.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
And it's, of course, our next taste of the upcoming album, Moral Panic. It is out on the 23rd of October. You've got this, you've got Is Everybody Going Crazy? It's shaping up nicely. And I think there's a lot of people out there that do want to know maybe just like a bit more of a gossip behind the album. Are there any surprises on there that we can expect?
I mean, in true Nothing But Thieves fashion, we actually can't physically write the same song twice. It's definitely a good thing. When we first started writing the first album, actually, shout out to Radio X, we were listening to you guys constantly. Yeah. I was driving to Dom's house and every day I'd listen to you guys, so it was very influential. The first album was just such an experiment that it led us, I think, I'd like to say, that we've now got the creative leeway to... do what we want. And then on this record, it's probably been quite funny where it's at points so expansive that we've had to kind of rein it in when we can, in a good way though. The actual title track, Moral Panic, is best described as a pessimistic Simon and Garfunkel song.
I like the sound of that. Well, it's a weird time for releasing music with obviously everything that's going on with COVID, but I feel like it's a time where people have sort of needed it. And I did want to ask, you know, the album's out in October, but have you got anything else up your sleeves for around the release or afterwards, maybe?
Gosh, I'm always getting in trouble with for giving stuff away, but...
Well, what you can say.
We've got something in, like, a week or two, and then something in 4 weeks.
Right.
Yeah, there's more stuff coming that's brand new within the next month, a couple of things, so...
Watch this space, then. I mean, you said that you can't obviously go out and play these things live, but one thing that I have sort of enjoyed seeing through lockdown, I guess, is where bands have taken it into their own hands and they've been playing sessions at home. And you actually did one of the Radio X phone covers and you did this brilliant version of Radiohead Creep. So, I mean, first off, well done on that, because that's not an easy song. I did want to ask, what made you pick that song? Are Radiohead a big band for you? Are they a big influence?
Radiohead is like my gospel. That's my version of a religion. It's just, I'm absolutely obsessed in every manner.
Well, it is sort of a topic that divides fans, but which is your favourite album?
If I have to live with one for the rest of my life, probably In Rainbows.
Yeah.
Maybe that's because I have rinsed OK Computer. I listened to it, I think, every day for a year at the age of, like, 14 or something. And so it's hard to listen to now. I actually listened to it today, weirdly enough.
Well, we've been doing this thing on the show, Connor, where we've been talking about the best gig memorabilia that we've held on to over the years. It's kind of like a little opportunity for people to boast. And I was going to ask if there's a band that you've ever really fanboyed over, but I think we can say it's probably Radiohead. So, for example, we had Andy from Doves on the other week. He's got a pair of Mike Joyce's sticks from an early Smiths gig. We had Simon from Biffy. He's got a pair of sticks from when he saw Tool. We had Bieber Doobie last week, actually. And hers was the other way around. It was a fan throwing a bra on stage at one of her shows, which she then kept hold of for the rest of the tour. So I did want to ask, Connor, what's the best bit of gig memorabilia that you've held on to over the years?
Any gig memorabilia? Oh, actually, I've got a funny one. I recorded the first album. I wouldn't say I'm a fan in the slightest, okay, but, you know, Dappy from N-Dubs left his Nike Air Forces at
That's a good claim. Yeah,
I just nicked them. Actually, I did tweet him saying thanks.
Are they the right size?
Yeah, just, they're very tight. He's quite, I mean, I'm a small bloke, but he's very small.
Well, I think that one could take the top of the leaderboard for now. Connor, thanks so much for talking to us today. It was, of course, our record of the week, Real Love Song. It's out now. Go and stream it. Go and enjoy it. And don't forget, the new album, Moral Panic, is out on the 23rd of October.
Cheers, man.